because my mom told me my dad wasn't shit to keep me away from my dad. But my dad didn't know. I'm 26, bro. I'm 26. My mom kept me away from my dad for 26 years. You know what kept me away from him? My mom told me that my dad said I was a mistake and kept me away from my father. He's been looking for him. Can you imagine all the kids out there whose mom's telling them their daddy ain't shit, but the daddy looking for him? I finally talked to my dad. He's a good dude. My mom told me my dad has not paid child support since I was a kid. Finally meet this. He has an envelope full of proof showing he's been paying child support. I have not talked to my mom in months. You know why? My mom called me. My mom's in California. My dad's in North Carolina. I moved out of L.A. I can't live in North Carolina or L.A. because I hate those places because of the trauma I went through on both of those places. My mom calls me. What you doing, baby? What's going on? I'm at my dad's house. That's nigga house. Didn't I say don't discuss family business? My dad comes and he busts through the door. My mom has been bitter and having sex with so many goddamn dudes of different races. She got married because she didn't want to be lonely. Dad busts through the door and snatched the phone. I was trying to, like, no. He snatched the phone. He put my son back on the phone. And I'm like, and he's like, he starts off calm. He's like, hello? Put my son back on the phone. No, it's my son too. What do you want? Put my son back on the phone. And my dad loses it. You've been musking my...
So you guys can go watch more on this on Mr. Let Go. But my opinion that I have the same, well, not same story. My father killed himself, but my mom was the, you know, major result of it. And she told me the same thing. My mom also told me my dad wasn't nothing. He beat her. He wasn't shit. You know, he wasn't worth anything. He didn't love, you know what I mean? He loved us, but he didn't love us. I didn't understand that after a while. But then my mom, you know, she ended up running the streets. You know what I mean? My mom literally had sex with damn near every race of dude. Like, the same story. I'm telling you, it's the same exact story and things like that. But they've never had a chance to have that closure because of my pop's, you know what I mean, death. But this is a real touching story to me because it matches well. Because of stuff like that was the reason why I ended up in foster care. And that what led me to where I am today. But this is a Grinchin story, man. I would love to speak more on, like, growing up and how this affected me. But I don't want to hold you guys too long. Thank you guys for tuning in, man. But this story right here, you guys got to go check it out. The guy at the top, his name is Mr. Let Go, and he's interviewing a guest. And you guys go check that out. Please go check that out. Y'all go follow Mr. Let Go on Instagram, also YouTube. But yeah, man, just if you guys are going through this story, it takes more men to come out and start talking how their moms deter them from wanting better. You know, this is a quick story, and I'm going to let you guys go. My mom, because I saw my mom ran the streets and prostitute and was just around so many dudes, and it was crazy because I would meet some of these dudes. My mom ended up being a madam. My mom ended up being, you know, like, it was crazy. We'll go more in details later. But the quick story is that I saw my mom coming out of a spot, and she always told me, you don't need to meet your dad. You don't need to talk to him. And you don't need to meet his family. I'm sorry. I wanted to meet my dad's family, and she would never let me meet his family. And until I met them myself, and I was like, oh, wow, they coolest, you know, freak. But it's those things, something that my mom didn't want to say, something that my mom didn't want to give across. It was something there. But thank you guys for tuning in. Really appreciate you guys. Dirty Off the Podcast. We put out that bull.